honored to present to you the senior video for the class of 2023, directed by Dallas Dudley. Dallas, Natalie Al-Shahabi, and Victor Paychev filmed and edited the video with assistant videographers Sienna Sauls and Williams Drubel. Please enjoy.
too slow. You need to catch up. You can dance and dance.
For a better way to get up out of bed instead of getting on the internet and checking a new hit. Get up, first shot, come strut walking. A little bit of humble, a little bit of cautious. Somewhere between like Rocky and Cosby's for the game. Look, look, y'all can't copy up. Glad, moonwalking. And this here is a party. My posse's been on Broadway, and we did it always. Wrong music, I shed my skin and put my bones into everything I record to it. And yeah, I'm on. Let that stage light go and shine on down. Got that Bob Barker suit game and Plinko in my style. Money. Stay on my craft and stick around for those pounds. But I do that to pass the torch and put on for my town. Trust me, on my I-N-D-E-P-E-N-D-E-N-T shit hustling. Chasing dreams since I was 14 with the portrait busting. Halfway across that city with the back question. Labels out here, now they can't tell me nothing. We give that to the people, spread it across the country. Labels out here, now they can't tell me nothing. We give it to the people. Spread it across the country.
Here we go back. This is the moment. Tonight is the night. We'll fight till it's over. So we put our hands up like the ceiling can't hold us. Like the ceiling can't hold us.
Here we go.
Meeting at the beat like it gave a little speed to a great white shark. I'm shark. We rock. Time to go off. I'm gone. Two says goodbye. I got a world to see. My girl, she wanna see Rome. See some make you a believer now. I never ever did it for a throne. That validation comes from giving it back to the people now. Sing this song and it goes like, raise those hands. This is our party. We came here to live life like nobody was watching. I got my city right behind me. If I fall, they got me. Learn from that failure. Gain humility. And then we keep marching.
That's it.
see it.
Memories.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Donald Gordon, and in just a few moments, we will commence the graduation ceremony for the class of 2023. At this time, please silence all cell phones and noise-making devices. Also, we ask that you maintain the proper decorum for a graduation ceremony. Please remain seated and refrain from all flash photography. A professional photographer will be taking pictures of your graduate. However, graduates may remain outside the north side of the building after the ceremony for those of you wishing to take personal photos of your graduate. In keeping with the decorum, we ask that you do not use air horns. We understand your excitement, however, loud noises may deny the recognition the next student deserves. Please hold your celebration until all graduates have been called. And now, ladies and gentlemen, will you please stand and remain standing in honor of the class of 2023.
Please remain standing for the presentation of the colors, followed by the Pledge of Allegiance and our national anthem. Please remove your hats. All members of the armed forces and veterans may render the military salute in the manner provided for individuals in uniform. Please remain standing until the honor guard exits the stage. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Please be seated. My name is Nishka Dalal, and I am the senior class treasurer. I would like to welcome all of you to this very special event. This graduation ceremony marks the end of a journey and the beginning of an adventure. The majority of seniors seated before me today have completed the entire six-year program at Edgewood Junior Senior High School. And to say that our high school years have been challenging is an understatement, but we have persevered. Today marks the beginning where all our ambitions become reality as we take the first step toward the people who we are meant to become. We will leave Edgewood and walk out into the world with poise, determination, and even a little fear. We take pride in who we are and the paths that we have chosen. Edgewood's Class of 2023 would like to thank all of you for your guidance and support. Now, we hope that you will share in our successes as we celebrate this very special and memorable moment.
Good evening. My name is Tanmay Kumar. I would like to take this opportunity to welcome our special guests, as well as thank them for being a part of our graduation ceremony. School Board Member, District 4, Chairperson, Mr. Matt Susan. School Board Member, District 2, Mr. Gene Trent. Chief Financial Officer for Brevard Public Schools, Ms. Cynthia Lisinski. Eastern Florida State College, Associate Dean, Transition Services, Ms. Christine Tripp. Former Assistant Principal for Curriculum and Instruction and Dean of Students for Middle School, Dr. Julia Diakakis. Former teacher at Edgewood Junior Senior High School, Ms. Catherine Alex. Assistant Principal for Curriculum and Instruction and Dean of Students for High School, Mr. Nick Stewart. Assistant Principal for Operations, Student Services, and Dean of Students for Middle School, Ms. Christy Flora. Class of 2023 graduate announcer, Mr. Alan Clark. And senior class sponsor, Ms. Melanie Kaiser. School Board Chairperson, Mr. Matt Susan, will now share a brief welcome.
I wanted to say thank you so much for allowing me to be a school board member. Many of you are inside of my district from the Vieira Sun Tree area, and I wanted to say it's an honor to serve you. I also want to say that I've done 36 of these graduations, and there's never been another school board member that sat with me. So I wanted to give a round of congratulations to Gene Trent in his first year as a school board member for making as many of the graduations as possible. That's a big deal. Thank you, Mr. Trent. I also wanted to let you guys know that one of the unique things about this school board is that it is the first school board not only to have four teachers that are on it, but also every single school board member actually has students that are inside of the schools. So we know exactly what's going on and we care deeply about what happens to our schools. I wanted to take a second and identify any of the veterans that are sitting inside of our audience that have served or are currently serving. Please stand up and take a round of applause. Thank you for your service. I also wanted to take a second and say thank you to the parents. The parents and sometimes grandparents who have raised some of the children that stand behind me. The individuals that stand behind me didn't just get handed a diploma. It's what you two and many of the other individuals inside your household have done in order to make this happen. I wanted to take a second and honor the actual heroes that I had, because I used to be a teacher and one of my former teachers is back here. I was going to ask all of the instructors and teachers to please stand up and be honored by the people that stand here. If you guys will stand up, please. These are the true heroes of Brevard. I just wanted to say, the world isn't going to hand you over success to some of the graduates. But if you're willing to work for it, there's more than you can imagine out there to grab onto. You might be upset. Some people, mostly people who don't want it as bad as you, will cause the world isn't dreamers and doers. Many of the individuals out there that are successful are also dreamers and doers. No one proudly dies with an "I had an idea once." They proudly die having chased that dream down, turning over every stone, pushing harder when things got hard, and making it come to life. Because social media might make it look like the world hands over success to those that are just the right place at the right time, and things are just happen for you. It's a lie. Right place, right time, and sheer grit and relentlessness is what makes it happen. And that's something that I wanted to thank the parents inside here. See, Edgewood usually gets this idea that they're the smartest kids in the world and they're just given everything. But the individuals that I know that are families out in this audience that I know personally, I know the struggles that many of you have made to make sure that the students that are behind here have actually taken the time and graduated with honors. And that is the story of Edgewood, the greatest leaders inside of our school district. I don't care about that other school that's a choice school south of us. You're better. So the bottom line is, yeah, I'll say it, and Dr. Fleming, you guys can all text him if you know him. I'm telling you, Edgewood's better, because that's our district. And I wanted to say, from the bottom of my heart, thank you for being BPS parents. Thank you so much for giving the time that you have to make sure that the students behind us are successful. And also, as their struggles go on and on, you're going to go through it, and all of you that are standing here today, each one of the struggles you go, each one of the levels has new devils, and each one of you are going to fight along the way. And the only way you're successful is if you believe in yourself and you follow your dreams and don't let anybody else take that from you. That's true success. That's what you do to win. And that's what makes Edgewood number one and what you guys are as parents number one. Thank you very much.
Ms. Jacqueline Ingrato will now deliver the principal's address.
Thank you so much, Mr. Susan. That was fantastic. Thank you. Distinguished guests, parents, guardians, grandparents, faculty, dignitaries, friends, and especially our graduates, the class of 2023, I welcome you to Edgewood Junior Senior High School's graduation ceremony. I am Jacqueline Ingrata, your school principal, and I am proud to preside over this commencement. I would first like to thank all of our men and women in uniform, active duty, retired, and law enforcement for your service. Please also join me in thanking our Edgewood Symphonic Band, under the direction of Mr. Andrew Kropp for our processional, Lindsay Angermeyer for introducing the senior class video, Donald Gordon for our prelude, Colton Turner for reciting the Pledge of Allegiance, our senior chorus under the direction of Mr. Joseph Franco for singing the national anthem, Nishka Dalal for our welcome, Tanmay Kumar for introducing our special guests, and Mr. Matt Susan, our school board chairman, for his presence and welcome this evening, as well as the presence of Mr. Trent. I would also like to recognize and thank the Honor Guard from the Brevard County Sheriff's Office for the presentation of the colors. I now wish to formally welcome you to this exciting moment as we gather here on this 24th day of May, 2023, to recognize, celebrate, and pay tribute to our Edgewood seniors. Graduation is a rite of passage in the young lives of these amazing students you see seated behind me. It brings together the hard work, dedication, and perseverance that was necessary to get to this moment, combined with the recognition for a job that was indeed well done. While today is the end of your high school journey, it is the very beginning of your very, very bright futures. Before we continue through our program, I would like to ask that you all join me in thanking and recognizing a few people who were instrumental in putting this event together and who have had a significant and profound impact on the seniors you see before us tonight. First, I would like to thank the entire staff at the Maxwell C. King Center for the Performing Arts for allowing us to use this beautiful venue. To Mr. Stewart, my right hand, who will take the blame for every mistake made this evening. Ms. Flora, who has not stopped running since her appointment this past January. And Dr. Diakakis, who made my professional world so easy. Thank you for never wavering in your support of me, even when I expect the impossible from you. To my support staff, who worked tirelessly to put this amazing ceremony together, thank you for calming me down after every event and for the stress of ensuring that our diplomas were ready on time. Love you, mean it. Just so you know, our diplomas came in last night. And now, I would like to take this moment to recognize and applaud our phenomenal Edgewood teachers. Your wisdom, knowledge, support, and love for the students seated behind me has never been greater or needed more than it is today. I truly admire each and every one of you, and I would like for our Edgewood faculty, staff, and administration on stage and out in the crowd to please stand and be recognized. Thank you. Finally, I would like to thank, honor, and applaud the parents, grandparents, and guardians, for you are the unsung heroes who have in many cases fought the seemingly endless battles of homework, service learning, athletic practices, academic competitions, extracurricular activities, senior project, advanced placement coursework, college applications, deadlines, scholarships, missed curfews, and the list goes on and on. It has been you who have remained constant in the lives of these seniors and to have set a solid foundation at home, which not only carries us to this moment, but sets the tone for a lifetime of success. I want to personally thank you for choosing Edgewood as your school of choice and giving us the opportunity to share in the education and development of your outstanding children. To the class of 2023, please stand and take this moment to thank your families for everything they have given you. You may be seated. And now, about the 17th graduating class of Edgewood Junior Senior High School, the class of 2023. This moment has finally arrived. The countdown is over, and this is most certainly a reality check for all of you here tonight that the class of 2023 is leaving Edgewood, where most of them have spent 6 years. Watching this phenomenal group of students mature from seventh grade to seniors has made me the luckiest principal. We had challenges, we had arguments. No, you cannot take the tires off the golf carts as a joke. We had successes, we had celebrations, and we had a pandemic. But these seniors had a somewhat normal junior year and a completely normal senior year. But I would never describe this senior class as normal. These students are truly special, and I could not be more proud. I recently read a commentary from a mother who experienced tragedy. She talked about students today are always looking down, down on the challenges they face, the adversity they feel, and the problems they are trying to solve. But if they will look up, they will see what can be, the opportunities, the possibilities, the potential. The class of 2023 is my class who always looks up. They dream, they are explorers, they seize opportunity, and they give us hope. They didn't start the fire, but they have grit and they have heart to solve problems and show compassion. In the words of Dr. Seuss and your class motto, you have brains in your head, you have feet in your shoes, you can steer yourself any direction you choose. You're on your own and you know what you know,
and you are the one who will decide where to go. You'll move mountains, and I am inspired that your next step is our next generation. Ladies and gentlemen, the class of 2023 has left their legacy at Edgewood. To be more specific, let me share with you the accolades and accomplishments of this most amazing class. We have, in this class, 132 graduates, and 130 of the class of 2023 are earning the Diploma of Distinction. Our valedictorian, Ms. Abigail Shepherd, earned the highest weighted grade point average of 4.73. Our salutatorian, Mr. Tanmay Kumar, earned the second highest weighted grade point average of 4.69. Mr. Brian Chang is the eighth recipient of the Dr. Kenneth Nguyen Edgewood Award for Excellence. We have nine seniors graduating with their Associate of Arts degree from Eastern Florida State College. 120 students are honor graduates with a 3.5 or higher weighted grade point average, and 23 are elite graduates with a 4.0 unweighted grade point average. Six of these students were named National Merit Commended Scholars or semifinalists, representative of being in the top 34,000 students out of over 1.5 million nationwide. Nine of these students are National Merit Scholar finalists, representative of being in the top 1% or 8,400 out of over 1.5 million students nationwide. Seven of these National Merit finalists went on to be recognized by the National Merit Scholarship Program as National Merit Scholars. 100 of our graduates earned Florida Bright Future Scholarships. 70 of these students are AP diploma candidates, having passed and taken a minimum of 6 AP courses while at Edgewood. 53 of these students are AP capstone diploma candidates, having taken and passed both AP capstone seminar and AP capstone research, in addition to 4 other AP courses. 45 of our graduates earned industry certification in a career in technical field. 130 out of 132 of these students will be entering either a 2-year college or a 4-year university to include flight school. One of these students will enlist in the military, and the cumulative scholarship earnings and offers for this most phenomenal class of 132 students is $10,470,791. And we are still counting. We got some more of those brought in this afternoon. Thank you, Ms. Kofer. Ladies and gentlemen, while these students didn't start the fire, I believe that the class of 2023 is ready to face the world's challenges with determination. To our parents and guardians, I would like to once again please know that we as a staff share in the celebration of this special day and this special moment, as we are extremely proud of these students. On behalf of Edgewood Junior Senior High School, I again thank you for partnering with us in educating these outstanding students, as it has truly been an honor and a pleasure to have been in your service. To the class of 2023, always look up and know that your dreams are unlimited. You are a very special group, and I thank you for being an inspiration to all of us here tonight. You are proven leaders, but remember that if service is beneath you, then leadership is beyond you. Maintain honesty and integrity as your guiding virtues. Stay focused in your work, have fun, laugh often, and be ever vigilant for the lesson within your failures. You have a great foundation. The rest is up to you. I want to congratulate you, class of 2023. I know that I am better because I knew you. So much of me is made from what I learned from you. You'll be with me like a handprint on my heart. I will miss you. Many blessings to you and your families. Thank you.
Good evening. My name is Megan Nguyen, and I'm the Senior Class Vice President. I would like to introduce our first graduation address titled Consistency Equals Excellence by Matthew Struble.
Good evening. Edgewood administration, faculty, staff, special guests, family, friends, and fellow graduates. Much can be said about the list of accomplishments from class of 2023. From awards and scholarships to sports and fine arts, our time at Edgewood has brought us great success. Even our successes and years together have had many changes. From different homeroom teachers to new class sponsors, the name and faces might have changed, but their support and guidance has had our best interests at heart. These changes are what make this class excellent. Change is part of growing up. We grow taller, learn more lessons, and laugh along again. That Sevi is not who we are now. Our parents might get sentimental, grab a tissue, and wonder what's happened to their baby. Still, there's something bigger associated with these changes. In order to grow and succeed, we must choose consistency. Whether it's on the athletic field or in the classroom, it is consistency that will build the foundation for our achievement. Consistency can offer a sense of comfort. It can be a routine or a familiar feeling. Athletes can appreciate standing on top of the podium. Does not just happen. From endless swim laps on a chilly morning to heavy arms from mastering the perfect swim, hard work and effort through consistency is valuable. By choosing to act, we are stronger regardless of success. A similar situation happens in the classroom. We all know the academic success at Edgewood is earned, not handed out. Whether it is choosing an AP class or an honors class, it is the choice to show up, to study, and challenge ourselves. Regardless of the academic score, the outcome may not reflect the consistency of our hard work. The recognition comes from completing the journey, just like choosing to show up to a sports practice every day. It is the progress, not the perfection, that is the achievement. Although we must be self-reliant in our journey, we need friends, family, and supporters in our corner. As we have found throughout the years, the class sponsors and homeroom teachers might have changed, but the role that they play in our success has never wavered. From power hour pep talks to the tutoring that clarifies a difficult lesson, the teachers foster our academic curiosity and the consistency as we strive to our goals. While we hope that this consistency will guide us forward, it may not be the direct path. But from support with others, stumbling is not a failure. Even if one step forward is met with one step back, we must continue to choose to move. We have built a personal expectation that through consistency of action, which will become routine. These people who support us are vital to our success. From the welcoming smile that brightens our day, to the rousing voice that can fill a theater. That occasional support enables us to take on that next challenge. Putting aside the occasional need for earmuffs, that well-meaning support should not be taken for granted. While our time at Edgewood has come to a close, the lesson learned and the memories made will not disappear once that cap and gown retires to the closet. From the uncertain Severies wandering the halls to our handprints on the senior wall, we have made our mark at Edgewood, and the experience has made the mark on us. Beyond the knowledge learned, the friendship gained, and the memories made, one key element unites them all: consistency, the foundation to any successful journey. Some people might prefer the loud voice cutting through the noise, and other people might prefer the sound of silence. No matter the scenario, I know each of us who chose to show up every day, put in the work, and persevered on this journey will be successful because of people in our lives who support us each step of the way. Congratulations, class of 2023. Consistency truly means excellence. We made it. Thank you.
Sophia Bills, Sophia Batar, Alexis Bravo, Brian Chang, Briah Cottrell, Jenna Golden, Ariana Gonzalez, Jenilyn Gunn, Alana Ho, Kayla Ho, Chloe Newhart, Kira Orndorff, Isabella Rose, Colton Turner, Brooke Wolfington, and Ian Woodrich will now perform Unwritten, written by Natasha Bedingfield.
stage before you. Open up the dirty window, let the sun illuminate.